Jake Beckett, who played football at Arkansas, went to the NFL, played for four seasons, won a Super Bowl with the Patriots, and then went on to Ranger School and was deployed to Iraq with the 101st Airborne Division. So kind of an underachiever type, you know. And so we were hoping to kind of maybe inspire him to do better in his life. We wanted to give him a little kick in the pants, see if we can get him going a little bit. Jake, welcome to The Blaze.
Well, hey, I appreciate that, and always love some good early morning motivation.
Good. Now, congratulations on everything you've done so far. You're only 32, right? And are you sure you want to go to Washington and be a part of this dysfunctional mess that's going on there?
Well, I want to go to Washington and actually represent conservative interests. I think the people of Arkansas want new leadership. They want bolder, younger, more dynamic leadership. And look, there's no better time than right now for new leaders to go to Washington, D.C.
So is your election coming up in November, or is it a year from now?
Well, the primary is in this coming May of 2022.
Okay.
In Arkansas, the Republican primary.
How many Republicans are running for this?
Well, there's a couple of other candidates who are challenging the incumbent, but we feel very confident it's going to come down to myself and Senator Bozeman.
Now, you served in Iraq, but like all the rest of us, you've seen what's going on in Afghanistan. Tell me how you're feeling about what just happened there.
Well, as someone who just recently left the Army, it's been very infuriating to see. A lot of my good friends have served in Afghanistan, the Middle East, and some have actually just returned from that debacle in Afghanistan. It just shows that leadership matters. And right now we have a commander-in-chief who's just totally weak and feckless. I would say incompetent, but it's hard for me to explain this in any other way other than it's deliberately weakening the United States of America. I truly believe that that's what the radical left is up to, both internationally and domestically. They want to destroy this country. And what we're seeing in Afghanistan is just a manifestation of that weakness.
So you do believe it's deliberate?
There's no other way. I mean, how else can you explain the tactical or strategic decision-making process of this president? I mean, abandoning Bagram Air Base, concentrating tens of thousands of civilians and military personnel on a civilian airstrip. I mean, Bagram was totally defensible. There was no way that the enemy could have dislodged us from that place. That's why it made no sense for us to abandon it in July. You had dual airstrips. You could have evacuated much more people much more quickly than we ended up doing. And that decision-making process led directly to the deaths of 13 American servicemen. It makes no sense other than it was deliberate. They just pulled the plug. And that's what I think is going on.
And yet he continually claims, the president continually claims that they couldn't have done any better, that this is just how it happens when you end a war. This is what it looks like. And, there's no way to do it better than this.
Well, the administration wants to have it both ways. Earlier in July, President Biden stood before the American people in that infamous press conference and said that the Afghan National Army was strong. They could stand up. They had a 300,000-man force that was supported by American military equipment and training. Of course, all that equipment is now in the hands of the Taliban. And now he wants to say, oh, this was inevitable. Okay, this country was always going to collapse. We all knew the ANA couldn't stand up against the Taliban. So, look, we can't let him use this sleight of hand. I think it's clear they just made a political decision that was devoid of any tactical or strategic sense, and it led directly to the deaths of 13 brave American servicemen.
We're talking with former Army Ranger and Super Bowl champion Jake Beckett, who's running for U.S. Senate in Arkansas. Jake, with things just in such a mess right now, I mean, we look at the wokeness of this country, the political correctness, the fact that we're changing our language, we're changing our values, they're actually working on changing our history. It's a lot like what Michelle Obama said that they were going to do. We're going to change our history. We're going to change our language. We're going to change our culture. And that's what they've done here What do you look at as the biggest issue that you face as a member of Congress should you win?
Well, I think you hit the nail on the head. I think if you want to be a leader in conservative politics right now, you have to understand the nature of the fight that we're in. You have to understand the nature of the radical left. These are not yesterday's Democrats, but they are yesterday's Marxists. You know, any student of history will understand that, you know, whether it be the French Revolution, the Russian Revolution, the Khmer Rouge, the Maoist Revolution, the Great Leap Forward, every Marxist revolution is exactly the same in the fact that they have to destroy the history of the previous regime. There can be no yesterday in a Marxist society. There always has to be the present and the future. And so I think that's what's happening in this country is they want to destroy our very foundations. They want to destroy our history. They want to destroy the very definition of what it means to be an American. And so we need leaders who truly understand this, who understand the lengths to which the radical left will go to fundamentally destroy this country, make us socialist and Marxist. So we simply cannot abide this. We need leaders who simply understand this and are willing to fight back as hard as the radical leftists are fighting against us.
What are your thoughts on the southern border? You live in a state that's not on the border with Mexico, but you're somewhat near it. So what would you do differently than we're doing right now?
Well, we have to have border security. I think it's been one of the great failures of the last 4 or 5 decades in both parties, to be quite frank. Both parties, both establishment wings of Republicans and Democrats have accepted promises of border security in exchange for amnesty. Okay, we can no longer do that. The Democrats want to do that with these latest budget proposals, and we can't let that happen. So we have to actually enforce our immigration law. We have to secure the southern border. That is square one. I'm not willing to negotiate on anything until I'm confident that the southern border is secure. And here in Arkansas, you're right, we're not a border state, but we are greatly affected by the wide-open southern border. By some estimates, over 2 million illegal immigrants will stream into this country in 2021 alone.
Right.
This crisis is in and out of the news cycle, but it's something that affects Arkansans every single day, and I'm not going to stand for it.
Now, how do you stand up to where do you stand on for instance, mandates, the mandates for masks and for vaccines? Now, your primary isn't until May and then the elections in November, but this could conceivably still be going on by then, or there could be another one down the road. So how do you handle the mandate situation with masks and vaccine?
Well, I'm against mandates in all forms. I believe in individual liberty. Like I think that if anyone wants to take the vaccine or wear a mask, they have every right to do so. But what they don't have the right to do is bully or coerce or force someone else to do so against their will. I think that's wrong. And unfortunately, I think that's what a lot of businesses and radical leftists, they're using this as a pretext to simply bully people into submission. And look, that's one thing that I've spoken out very strongly about. It's something that Republican voters in Arkansas care very deeply about, and I believe in individual liberty.
Where do you stand in the polls right now? How are you doing so far? Do they have polls out on the primary yet?
No, so we launched about 7 weeks ago, so the campaign is still very new, but look, we had some very compelling data internally that suggests that people of Arkansas are ready for a change. We're seeing it in fundraising. We're seeing it in the events we're going to all over the state. We've had a lot of great momentum, a lot of enthusiasm, and we think that's going to continue.
Okay. Your website is jakebequette.com, JAKEBEQUETTE.com. We'll probably post that right on Twitter.
Just did.
Yeah, because it's
So if you just want to click on...
Hard to remember.
Yeah, go to Pat Unleashed on Twitter, and then we've got a link there at the top.
Okay.
JakeBeckett.com.
Man, I wish you all the luck in the world. I don't envy you your job because it's getting tougher and tougher just to cut through all the nonsense and make any sense in this world. I mean, you can't even say things that are science-based anymore. Talk about biology anymore without being beaten to death on Twitter or canceled somewhere or drummed out of office. So I don't envy you the job, but I wish you all the luck in the world.
Well, thank you. Hey, it's a worthy cause. I love this country. I wore the uniform to stand up and fight for my beliefs, and I want to do the same thing in the U.S. Senate. And I appreciate you having me on. I I'm a patriot, and we need more patriots who are willing to sacrifice everything for this country.
Thanks a lot, Jake. Appreciate it. Good luck.
Take care.